All right. Welcome back to Eyes Open Media. Prophet John here. Hope you guys are doing well. All right, so it is day 14 of the detox. Feeling a lot better today. So we're gonna continue. I didn't eat a meal yesterday, so I have a salad in the fridge, but I don't even want the salad. I did have a smoothie with kale and fruits in it, blueberries and things like that. So I did have that yesterday. I had two of those yesterday. So, you know, when you have those, you know, when you take water with apple cider vinegar and sea moss jelly in the morning, you're really much full the rest of the day. But I had a smoothie. I had a fruit smoothie with with the minerals in it, and then I had another one for dinner. And so I was good there all day. I didn't have to eat a meal or anything like that. So I do have a salad, but I don't even know if I'm going to eat the salad or not, today. All right. If I don't eat the salad, I'll probably throw it out. You know, salads are basically only good for like, what, 3 days, you know, at the max 4 days, but I wouldn't even push it that far. What else is going on? Well, it's Saturday, May 1st, so it's 9 a.m. in the morning. I wanted to actually sleep in a lot more, but I woke up at 8, so the crypto markets are doing very well here. 2.22 trillion market cap there for the cryptos, so, you know, doing really well. Bitcoin's up almost 6%, you know, Dogecoin's up 15%, Ethereum's up almost 5% today, so. You got a whole bunch of coins doing really well. And let me go down and see if T-Fuel is, how T-Fuel is looking like. T-Fuel, 35 cents, up almost 7%. So, it's starting to move a little bit. So, I'm watching T-Fuel here because, you know, we're within 60 days from Mainnet 3.0 launch when T-Fuel staking will go completely live. And, you know, right now it's in beta. But it's going to go completely live, we'll be able to stake T-Fuel. And, we know, some of us stake data right now, but we'll be able to stake T-Fuel officially when Mainnet 3.0 goes live. I want to do mine on the G-Pool. I don't want to actually run a node. I want to do mine on G-Pool. So hopefully G-Pool will be open on day one within hours after Mainnet launch goes live. Everything goes live. Hopefully G-Pool goes live as well with Theta Fuel, and we don't have to wait a couple, like 3-4 days for that. Maybe we just have to wait maybe an hour or 2 hours or 3 hours on that, hopefully. Okay, and they make it live and we're able to stake on G-Pool, just like we do on Theta. So that would be cool if we can do if that happens on day one as well. I don't know, we haven't heard anybody from G-Pool say anything about that yet, so we just have to wait and see. But it shouldn't take much. I mean, you know what I mean? When 3.0 goes live, you know, beta staking on T-Fuel, you know, ends, and then the elite edge nodes go completely live, and you know, and then they should be able to run a pool from there on G-Pool for everybody else. All right. So I guess we'll see how that plays out, though. We'll see how quick they can get that done so we can start staking on G-Pool. But, and if they don't get that done, then all I'm going to do, what I'm going to do is, if for some reason that G-Pool doesn't want to do T-Fuel staking for some strange reason, what I would do is, watch T-Fuel run up. And I would price T-Fuel in, and if T-Fuel, once I think T-Fuel has topped out, I would swap all my T-Fuel for Theta then. You know what I mean? So I wouldn't just sell it because, you know, it's not on G-Pool. I'll wait for it to top out. So if the top out price is $5 or $3 or $2.50 or $1.75, whatever the top out price is on the charts, you know, before we get that nice little double top or shooting star or whatever the case may be, then I will swap it for Theta, and then continue to stake Theta. Just, you know, have a little bit more. Now, of course, maybe I don't swap it for Theta. Maybe I just cash it out. Because data could be at $40 at that point or $80 at that point, and it probably wouldn't even make sense to swap it for data. Maybe I'll swap it for another coin that's about to take off, like Bidal coin, or because they have a mainnet coming up in a couple of months, right? So in the next 6 months, they're gonna launch their mainnet in like the next 6 months. So maybe that's a coin. Bidal coin might be a coin that I might want to put to make sure I get maybe 10 million coins in that one. Who knows? Who knows what I'm gonna do? But I'm hoping that G-Pool does allow us to stake T-Fuel. And there should be no reason why they don't. And everything works out, and we're making nice passive income. Okay. Now today is Silver Day. Silver Squeeze Day is today, where I guess people go out and buy physical silver and try to basically take power back from the corrupt and have physical silver in your possession. All right. So I don't know how many people are participating in this, but a whole bunch of people are going to go to sites and they're going to buy out the silver coins and bars at the on these all these websites and try to take power back from the elites. So we'll see. I don't know if that's going to be the case or not, but I guess it's going to be fun to see how that plays out. I guess we'll get the results on Monday or next week. We'll get the results to see if exchanges are sold out of silver, you know what I mean? But if they're not, then it was just a fun little thing to try to maybe scare people, scare the bankers a little bit there. but anyways, hope you guys are doing well. We still haven't heard anything from Arizona. There was a massive earthquake somewhere. But I saw Benny post something about an earthquake, 7.8 earthquake. It was somewhere. I don't remember where it was, but man, that was a big boom. So we finally got a boom, but it was somewhere, a place that I don't know nothing about. So, but yeah, we haven't heard anything about the audits yet from Arizona. They're fighting that from tooth to nail. So they must have a lot to hide if they're fighting this thing, man. Those audit results should have already been out, right? So I mean, you do the forensic audits, and then you put the results out. I mean, why would people be fighting that? What's wrong with forensic audits from a third party, going through the watermarks on the balance sheets? Why is that so wrong? Apparently it is. Apparently the people think that it's wrong to do that. You're racist, or you're not an American if you're doing forensic audits on watermarks on ballots. It's unconstitutional. They're making up all types of stuff now. I mean, I mean, both sides have lost their minds. And so I try not to entertain that stuff any longer. I don't let it get to me anymore. I don't even care anymore. I just do my thing with my people, with my team that support me, and I support them. And I want my team, the Currency 365 team, my social media team that are with me in a Telegram group, that are with me here, with me on Currency 365, with me on Patreon. You know what I mean? I want my team to succeed, right? I want my team to succeed. I don't care what the politicians do. I want my teams to make millions of dollars so that they can take care of themselves and their family members and friends, don't have to even live on the system. Can go completely solar, can go completely do their own thing, grow their own foods, eat healthy, live a great life, and not even have to worry about the politicians of America. Yeah. So anyways, for those that I have a Theta T Fuel address underneath these videos in the description section. So if you want to help me, I'm trying to get back to a million T Fuel because I want to be able to use that. If I can stake that on GPool, I'll be able to use those funds, that those T-fuels that I'm going to be getting in rewards. I'd be able to use that to bless a lot of people. If I can get back to a million T fuel. But people don't like to give, so I'm not gonna be asking anymore. Because people don't like to give. People don't like to give at all. So it's fine. People, I mean, you don't have to give to me. People give to other people. I understand that as well. But I just thought about it like, man, if I can get to a million T fuel again, man, I could do a lot of good with that because I'm going to be earning like 1,000 T fuel a day, right? If you got a million T fuel, aren't you going to be earning like 1,000 when Mainnet 3.0 comes out? You'll be earning like 1,000 to 1,500 T fuel a day. It's got to be somewhere in that range. Maybe, yes. It's got to be somewhere between like 900 to 1,500 T fuel a day. You would think. Right, I could be wrong, but it's got to be somewhere around that. And man, if T fuel is at like $3 to $5, man, I could do a lot of good with that, man. I could send people T fuel all day long, man. You know what I mean? Especially my people on Patreon. I could be blessing people's lives. Like I could be changing people's lives with if I'm earning, 1,000 T fuel a day and T fuel is at $5, that's $5,000 a day, right? And I could send those T fuels out through my private wallet. It's not tax. There's no tax on that for me to send it through my private wallet. My, you know what I mean? And just be sending it to the 365 Eyes Open Media crew that's on Patreon with me. You know, I could be blessing a whole bunch of people doing that. And so, but people don't care about that stuff, so it's all good. But yeah, anyways, we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens with T Fuel. We'll see if it can get to $5. We'll see what happens with everything else. All right. So XRP, we're looking for what, 250 to 380 range. Hopefully in the next 10 days, we see that. Bitcoin, looking for 78,000 plus Bitcoin in May. What about Redcoin? Is Redcoin ready to go or what, man? Hopefully by the first quarter of next year, Redcoin's $1. Then that's the goal, right? The goal is to have Redcoin $1 by the first quarter of next year. And if that's the case, then a lot of you guys are gonna have a lot of smiles on your face because the dollar's still gonna be strong by then, and it might fall just maybe a little bit more. Maybe it might be at 85 by then or something like that, but it's still gonna be strong in the world reserve currency most likely, unless something drastically changes with XRP and the IMF and things like that. But I still think they might coexist or something. I don't know, but yeah, if Redcoin is $1 by first quarter next year, I think we'll be fine. Okay. So what else is going on? There's legislation to stop the passport, the vaccine passports, right? So let's see what else is going on. So that's good. People are fighting against those, and I don't think people have had a lot of problems with that, anyways. Right, at least right now. So, I pray for everybody to have wisdom on that, on the shot, and stay healthy. Don't put poison in your body. Don't do it. I don't care what anyone says. Just don't put poison in your body like that. You're already eating poison with the chips and Doritos and all the other stuff that we eat. So, don't do it with a freaking shot. Stay healthy. You know what I mean? Stay healthy. You want to be able to. You want to be. Imagine being unhealthy and you getting all this money, but you're unhealthy. You know what I mean? It sucks. So stay healthy. Stay away from poison, and live your life. All right. So let's get into some prayer. Let's do a quick prayer. What are we gonna pray about? Let's pray about our heart. A lot of people have heart disease and heart problems and heart failures and triple beating hearts and irregular hearts, and people have get heart attacks and strokes and things like that. So let's pray for the heart. Heavenly Father, we lift ourselves up today, and we come before you humble. We ask you for repentance. We repent for our sins now, of every sin that we have committed and done, every sin that you have seen, every sin that the angels have seen, every sin that Yeshua and the Holy Spirit have seen. We repent for it now. Every sin that's unseen, we repent for it now. Every sin in the dark and the light, we repent for it now. In Yeshua's mighty name, we repent for every sin that we have committed and done, and we put it under the blood and under the feet of Yeshua and under the Holy Spirit. And we ask the Holy Spirit to wash us clean now with the baptism. We believe in the baptism of the Holy Spirit. We believe in Yeshua, our Savior, in Yeshua's mighty name. We thank you, Father. We also cancel every demonic dream. We cancel every demonic thought, every demonic plan, every demonic vision. And we send it back to the sender, hellfire and the spiritual realm where it comes from. And we do the same with everybody else's dreams, thoughts, and visions of us. We all cancel every negative thought from other people and ourselves. And we shall never let it allow it to come to pass. We seal it with the blood of Yeshua and the power of the Holy Spirit, and we terminate it now in Yeshua's mighty name. Father, we come to you. We ask you to cover us with the blood, cover us from the top of our heads to the bottom of our feet, heal us of every sickness and disease, and set us free from the evil torture, the evil powers, evil demons. We torture we torture the demons to come out in Yeshua by the blood of Yeshua. And the power of the Ruach and the Holy Spirit, demons come out now and set us free. Evil come out now and set us free. Sickness come out now and set us free. Allergies come out now and set us free. Cancer come out now and set us free. AIDS come out now and set us free. STDs come out now and set us free. Tumors come out now and set us free. Blood clots set us now come out now and set us free. Heart attacks come out now and set us free. In Yeshua's mighty name, arthritis come out now and set us free. In Yeshua's mighty name, liver problems come out now and set us free. Colon problems come out now and set us free. Stomach problems come out now and set us free. Gas problems come out now and set us free. In Yeshua's mighty name, rib problems come out now and set us free. In Yeshua's mighty name, eye problems. Those who can't see or barely see, Father, may you touch their eyes down and let them be set free and let them see perfectly. 20/20 vision and better in Yeshua's mighty name. We thank you, Father. Lung problems, we come out now and set us free and let us breathe normally in Yeshua's mighty name. Father, we touch our hearts right now, protect it with the Holy Spirit, and put the blood of Yeshua over our hearts right now. And Heavenly Father, every problem with the heart is healed now in Yeshua's mighty name. Every problem with everybody's heart is healed now. Father, touch our hearts now and heal our hearts from any sickness, any disease, and any problems. Let our hearts beat regular. Let our hearts be powerful. Let our hearts be strong. And remove every fat around the heart. Remove every problem around the heart. And let the heart beat free and steady in Yeshua's mighty name. And we cover our hearts with the blood of Yeshua and the power of the Ruach HaKodesh, Holy Spirit. In Yeshua's mighty name, our hearts will stay until we return to you. Our hearts will beat until we return to you. We will not die from any heart problems in Yeshua's mighty name. We thank you, Father. Our hearts beat for you, and they beat for the kingdom of God in Yeshua's mighty name. We pray. Shalom, Father. Set us free from every pain, every sickness in this detox time that we're in. In Yeshua's mighty name, we pray. Shalom, shalom, shalom. All right, guys and girls, hope you guys enjoyed the video. We're just vibing. I don't do videos on Currency 365 on the weekend, so this video was a little bit longer because of that. I'm just vibing with you guys. I love the picture I'm looking at there with the apple there with the kale and everything. So I think there's a lemon or something to the side on the right there. Yeah, you know what I mean? A nice little detox picture there. You know, and then my voice comes in. It's like Barry White talking to the ladies or something. I don't know. But anyways, it's funny. God bless you. And I'll see you guys tomorrow as we continue to detox. This is day 14. So tomorrow's day 15 already. And with a snap of a finger, we're going to be 30 days in this thing. And then And then we're going to be 60 days in it, and then we're going to be 90 days completion. And by that time, God knows what the world's going to look like, you know, and it's going to be really interesting to see the financial system when this 90 days is over, and how we look, and what the cryptos have done in these 90 days. It's going to, you know what I mean? So it's going to be a crazy ride. Maybe T-Fuel will be at $5. Maybe Theta will be at $88. Who knows, man? You know, what about Ethereum? Ethereum could be, God, who knows? It could be way up, or it could be at $10,000, or it could be at back to $1,500. Who knows, man? But it's gonna be a fun ride. Peace out. God bless. Eyes open.